Hello everyone, welcome. Here is the first lesson in our training workshop, and we will make this low poly building. And it's low poly and it's based on some modeling and hand painted. So if you can use Photoshop and if you can use 2D painting, well, so you can easily make this model. And here is another image, another type of the building, and here is another view. So we have around 3 building, and you can build this using the modular method or the regular one. Here is the column, it's repeated, and some walls, the stairs, the roof, and so on. Alright, it's so easy. Let's start our file. So firstly, we can add or make the stairs. We can add here an a plane and scale it on y.2 and add go to the edit mode. Let me switch to the screencast case. You can check here what I am typing on my keyboard. So that's fine. Let's extrude to be here, and I will add two loop cuts now and move in the Y slightly on the Y, and after that you can move again on the Y, and after that you can, let's increase the height and select that and make an bevel. If you can see, it's not regular, so just apply the scale. If you go here in the item, you can see the scale, it's not applied, so you just press Ctrl A and apply the scale. Here we are. And we can add the bevel now. You can slide that. And we have another shape. So let's select this face and add a plane. Rotate around the X, scale on the X, and move like that. Right now, I will move that here. Right. Right, now I can make the cursor to be here, maybe here, and press Alt E spin. 90 is perfect, minus 90, or we can extrude and press Control. Right click, scale Z to be 0. Right, select all and extrude in the X. That's fine, and we can add mirror on this direction on the X, and you can press Ctrl B and you are now done. This one just add array on the y and on the z. And let's see, on the z will increase the array like that, and it's 3. So let's see, let's increase the z axis here, so we can select this part and using the proportionating to move in the y, scale on the y. And move that. So we have modeling finished the stair. We can name it here the stairs. Let's add another collection. We will name it column. So for the column, it's very simple. Let's add a plane dimensions, maybe 0.4, and select that and scale. Select all and extrude in the Z, maybe 2 meter. And let's scale that. And that's it for the column. Of course, when we add texture, it will be fine. We have also the wooden plates or the wooden floor. So it's very simple. Let's add a plane, maybe 0.2. And scale on y, scale on y 6, add extrude here, and another array, the factor may be 1.01, and let's say the count will be 7, and we can add the bevel to be 1 and 0.01, maybe divide it by 3. You can alright, we will add the details later, but it's fine for now, and we'll move that to be floor. So that's it for this lesson. In the next video, we'll continue making the walls for our building. Alright, so in the video, we're going to make the walls. We will start from a plane as usual, and I will rotate it in the X 90 degrees, move in the Z. So I will move in the Z, press Shift, and we can move that in the Z. So let's see the dimensions. It's now plus rotation, it's now 1 meter. Let's say it will be 2 meter, and in the X it will be 3 meter maybe, and we have to add here loop cut, and another loop cut at the top. That's fine. So we can duplicate that and separate by selection and move in the Z so I will move to this edge and extrude in the Z to this edge so that the thickness is around 10 centimeter. And let me extrude to this edge. I will add 3 loops and delete all these vertex and add another array 4. Maybe 1.01, some bevel, maybe 0.01 divided by 2, and I'll fill that. So we are now done, and we have another wooden edge here, so we can make it by Alt Z, Alt D, and press Z. So here we have the duplicate linked Alt D. That's fine. And what we should make, I will delete maybe separate this face and select this one and move in the X axis like that and add array 1.002 maybe and another so we can extrude on the Y. And add bevel. Multiplied by 3 maybe. And that's fine. And we have here some metal, so we can make by adding a circle, the vertex maybe 20, and rotate around the X, scale down, delete this part, and this part, and delete the edges. Extrude in the Z and extrude in the X axis. We can scale and let's extrude scale. Move that in the Z and descale that and let's add extrusion. I will add the mirror. Maybe we add the mirror on the X and the Z, but we want the cursor to be here, so I will add an empty plane axis and name it EM wall, and using the EM wall, so we are now done. So it's now done, but of course we will add material later. So this is the side wall. We can select all and press M to move to the side wall. But we want to make the entrance. So let me explain that. So we have the side wall here, window, and the wall, and here is the entrance. It's exactly as the side wall. Here we have window and here we have the door. So that's it for this lesson. In the next video we will make the front wall, and of course we will model the door. Alright, so let's continue what we have left in the previous part. And let me add a plane. This plane has 3 meter by 3 meter. But I will extrude this one in the x-axis 3, and this one in the x-axis minus 3. And I can, after that, extrude in the z maybe 3 also, or 2.7. And I will move in the Z maybe 0.3, and after that I will select this point and select this edge and duplicate, and after that I will separate. Then we can extrude in the Y and move in this direction. That's fine. And let me extrude in the Z axis. So this is a support number one. Let's say the length or the height maybe 15 centimeter. Let's see. So we can move minus 0.05, and it should be scaled on X to this area, and we must have two. So this is the main building. This is the main, and we can mirror that on the Y direction based on this main. That's fine. After that we can select this edge, duplicate again, and separate by selection, and select that and extrude in the Z. That's fine. But let's move that here. Or we can move in the X axis. And scale on Y. And of course we will mirror that on the X based on the mean. That's fine. And here we will add the column, but after texturing. So in this area we have here we have the entrance and the floor, and we can select the floor. Selecting the floor and move here, we can scale and using the stairs, selecting the stairs and move here. So let's see the floor will be here. And all the building must be raised, maybe here. And now we will scale that. I will extrude that in the Z. And extrude that again. Alright, we can add another here. We add another wooden plate and I will select this edge and I will add maybe select this edge and duplicate and separate by selection. I will remove the array and leave the bevel. Then we can enable the vertex, move to be here, extrude in the Z and extrude in this direction. Amazing. We can also add the mirror based on the main, no problem. Move that to be here. Alright. That's fine. Let's select this face and separate by selection. Move in the Y, selecting this face, and I will extrude to this element. Let's re-enable the stairs and move on the Y. All right. So let's check the column. I will move it. Let's call it column and I will move it to be here exactly at this point. Once we have made one, we can make the all the same. I will scale and move in this area and after that I will move this point to be here. That's fine. After that, we can scale. That's fine. We have to duplicate the side wall. Select this object, rotate around the Z 90 degrees. And we can move here. So let's scale on Y. And scale in the Z. And we are now done. Or the side wall. We can now add the window. It's called right and for the window it's very simple. Let's start here fresh and we can add an circle, large circle, maybe 24 and here maybe 2 and rotate around the y 90 degrees and move to be here. Select all of that. I'll delete all these vertex and extrude scale and let's mirror, set the origin to the 3D cursor and the mirror around the Y. Let's add some thickness. What we have made, we can duplicate that to be here and rotate 90 degrees. And rotate again like that. Control MZ. Select all and Control MZ. Move in this direction. And scale on the Y. That's fine. Let's select this edge and now we can duplicate and separate by selection. Scale on the X and let's extrude on the Y and move and extrude that's fine. We can separate this item and rotate 90 degrees we don't need the mirror and here we don't need the mirror and for this one let's move on the Y and add an array on the Y of course let's apply the array and manually scale these parts. And I will scale, select all and scale on the X 0.7 and here I will select all and scale on the x.8 maybe, and we can add the gloss. Shift S core selected and add a plane. Rotate around the y 90 degrees. Let's scale. Scale on the Z. Let's scale down. So I will select all of that and move to window, and here we are. We can move that here, maybe scale down and just move in the x axis. Here, that's fine. In the next video, we will continue modeling our building.